Siam, thank you so much. Mary Taylor Townsend here into round three. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Your first top 20 win. You didn't know before somebody told you. 0-13 before today. First top 20 win. How does that feel?
Really good. I mean, I think playing Halep in Miami gave me a lot of confidence. Even though the score was not very close, I thought I played a pretty solid match, and I was really excited to get back on the practice court and keep working.
And so you beat Julia Gerges today. Do you remember the fact that back in 2014, when you were a teenager, you actually beat her in D.C.?
Yeah, I knew I played her one time, but I knew it was like ages ago. It felt like ages ago. So, I mean, I try not to think about that because, I mean, it's so many years later and she's a different player, I'm a different player. So I try to discard that and just think about today.
So what worked best for you on the court today?
I just think that I really stuck to my game plan and I stuck to what I do best. And even though there were some up and downs, like I just stayed consistent with like what I was trying to do. I didn't really try to change too many things and get too flashy. I just think that I was really solid.
So you made your debut on the WTA 6 years ago. How would you characterize your progress up till now?
Yeah, it's been a bumpy road, I think. But I think I've learned how to manage expectations, manage myself, and get good people around me so that I'm able to go in the right direction, which is forward. I mean, everybody who, you know, has gotten me to where I am up until this point, I'm thankful, but you know, I've got really good people around me and I'm in a really good headspace right now, and I just take it a day at a time.
One of those people, Donald Young Sr., he's with you on the court here in Charleston. What has he done? What's the biggest thing he's done to help your game?
Well, I think his biggest message is like accepting where you are that day, you know, so sometimes things aren't great, sometimes things aren't the way that you want them to be, but you have to adjust and you have to keep finding a way to just keep working. And I think that's one of the biggest messages that I can take away, because it transfers not only on the court, but in life in general. Like, you just have to keep pushing, you know, even though things could get bad or ugly, like, you just got to keep going.
Yeah, absolutely. And last year, you finished inside the top 100 for the first time in your career. What did that mean to you to kind of show that you've made it and kind of have that significance to make a Grand Slam without having to qualify?
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, I think that last year was a lot. I could take a lot of positives from it. I mean, it was super exciting. I was able to win a round in 3 out of the 4 Grand Slams, which is something I had never done before. So it was milestones and it was steps. You know, some people have huge leaps, but you know, I'm taking it in a day at a step at a time so that I can replicate it and I know how to get there and then get farther and farther.
Step at a time. Got your first top 20 win. Now you're into round 3.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank
we
you.
Wish you the best of luck going forward. Love
Thanks.
To have you here.
Thank